In this video, we will look at a small but very useful feature available inside of Voice-O-Matic. Here I have a head set up with various morph targets in the morpher modifier. This head has already been set up with Voice-O-Matic. I will simply open Voice-O-Matic's interface, and I will use the active audio file in the scene to automatically create the lip sync animation. Clicking the Create Keys button will create the automatic lip sync animation immediately. So let's have a look at the results.
With Voice-O-Matic, create quality lip sync in a snap. With Voice-O-Matic, create quality lip sync in a snap.
That's pretty cool, right? But what I really want to show you is how to adjust the tangent type of your animation curves. To do this, we actually need to go into 3ds Max's interface and select the type of tangents we want. For the sake of this example, I will use stepped keyframes. Now if I hit Create Keys, a completely new animation is generated.
With Voice-O-Matic, create quality lip sync in a snap.
Using stepped keyframes made this animation look very claymation-esque. And as you can see, this is also very apparent looking at the animation curves. Now what's very cool is that we can just go back and change our tangent type, hit Create Keys again, and Voice-O-Matic will create brand new animation curves according to the tangent type you have chosen. So you can easily change the look of your animation by just adjusting the tangent type of your keyframes inside of Voice-O-Matic. Thank you for watching this quick overview on how to adjust custom tangent types when animating lip sync animations with Voice-O-Matic. For more information and to download the trial version of Voice-O-Matic for 3ds Max, please visit our website at www.di-o-matic.com.